So we're at another abandoned mine. This one's an inclined shaft going down here at a 30-degree angle and 900 feet deep. So we're going to go check it out. So we're headed down that way, and here's looking back up the incline. And that's Nick. And there's going to be a little slide-out car that'll appear in the right upper right-hand corner of the screen right about now. And that'll be a link to his channel. And he's been exploring abandoned mines for the last year or so and has a lot of cool videos on his channel. So go over there and check those out. But we're going to head down this incline and see what's down here. And you can see this is like a, this roof is like a, I guess to keep out snow, probably, in the wintertime. And then we're headed down there. So check out that roller attached to that timber. That was probably used to facilitate the cable that was pulling up the ore carts from this inclined shaft that continues down that way. So that's looking back up, and check out, here's some old resistors or insulators or whatever those are called right there on that timber for the electrical wiring that was once in here. And then we're slowly making our way down. There's another little pulley right there. Don't know what that was used for. That's a real small one. But we're going to keep heading down that way.
Very careful. Looks like we've got a little lip of dirt, a little rock that we can support ourselves with, but you're going to get some strange angles as I'm going down.
Okay, so as we make our way down here, we have a map of this mine, actually, and it shows this right there where my light is. There's about a 125-foot vertical shaft there that the tracks go over, and that leads to a lower level that we're not going to get to today, obviously, but we can pass by it safely here on the right next to the pipe. There's a ledge here. It looks about maybe a foot and a half wide, but yeah, that's a 125-foot drop. And then Nick's making his way down there. It's open. The shaft is open, so we're going to keep going. It's 900 feet, so we've only come down about 100, I think, if even that. So lots more to see. Okay, Nick made it past this hole that goes down 150 feet. You have to go down this ledge right here in front of me. It's about a foot and a half wide, maybe 2 feet, if even that. But I'm having second thoughts just because that is a sheer drop off, and all I have to walk on is what he used. And it's all solid for the most part, but I'm just afraid of heights like that. And that's a serious drop off, about 125 foot shaft there going down. Okay, so Nick went down there a little further, and there's another hole in the shaft, but the only way across it is to shimmy across a pipe, basically. There's not even a ledge. The same pipe you see right here in front of me. And then it looks like past that, it's collapsed anyway. So unfortunately, this 900-foot shaft has turned out to be a no-go. Just because there's a collapse and there's these two dangerous holes that just really aren't worth the risk, especially the one down there where he was, where there's just a pipe. We're not going to shimmy across a pipe. That's just crazy. So it's only a 12-foot drop, that hole, but it's hard to get out of a 12-foot hole. I mean, you know, so we're going to just call it quits and go check out some other stuff maybe. Yeah, I've never seen an inclined shaft like this that has a drop-off 100 and some feet. I've been down many inclined shafts and never seen that kind of a feature, you know, so kind of unusual. But anyway, we won't see what's down the rest of the 800 feet of the shaft, so unfortunately. That is sketchy.
A lot easier coming up than it was going down, though.
Yeah. Man. So there's this big collar here over a pretty deep vertical drop. Here's a shot looking down. So this building houses a bunch of core samples back when they were out here drilling, seeing if this mine was worth opening. Yep. These are the core samples. That's a lot of them.
They're all over the place.
There's like a water heater back there or something. See that? There's a water heater.
It's a big one.
So more core samples tucked away back here, stacked up pretty neatly. This water heater carving, I bet that's asbestos. It probably is. But yeah, a major core sample depository. Yeah, they label each box, I guess, with the coordinates of, you know, of where the sample was taken, the date maybe, and then they just leave them here, I guess.